Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, get dressed. Put some clothes on.
Yeah.
Driving naked. You. Morning everyone and welcome back to the channel. My name is Florin. Thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. You're joining me on this beautiful day. Not the sun is shining. Not yesterday and the day before, the sun was out there doing his job. Today when I decide to film a vlog, it's like this. Anyway, I filmed a little bit yesterday, but it was the same kind of vlog that I did previously. So I'm not gonna repeat myself on the jobs. I'm trying to give you something new. So that's why today I've decided to start filming again and give you a little bit different content. Still SDGO work, because we are delivering a smaller bridge girder, 30 ton and 17.7, I think, meters long. We use different trailers for that, which we don't have, but I'm going now to rent a trailer from Hudson's in Doncaster, near Doncaster Sheffield Airport, anyway, that way. So we're gonna rent a trailer. There's one thing that they don't provide though. It's the timbers, you know, the sleepers that we need for the job. They don't provide that. Ideally, it would have been if they provide timbers, so we can rent the trailers with the timbers and then give the trailers back with the timbers on. That would be fantastic. Or there's another way, when we go to pick up the steel beams, maybe we can get timbers there, but it's a hit and miss. Sometimes they have timbers there, spare timbers, sometimes they don't. So it is what it is. I think we're gonna have to come back and get our own sleepers and sort it out that way. Anyway, it's four of us doing the job, but two of my colleagues are delivering today, Mark and Mark. Two marks. they are delivering today, and me and Steve are delivering tomorrow. Actually, there is a little issue as well with booking times for this HS2 site. We are booked for 9 o'clock, but we cannot be there for 9 o'clock because of the morning embargoes and evening embargoes if you're traveling far, like we're gonna do today. So yeah, it's not 9 o'clock is not possible. It is what it is. We'll go with the flow, and I think we're gonna be there as normal at 11:30 tomorrow instead of 9. But we'll see, guys. I will come back to you when we are close to Hudson Trailers. All right, see you in a bit. So we are here almost. I think that's Steve coming back already. Oh, he's not. He went a different way. He went a different way. He came from the other side. Now, I really hope they're gonna have our trailers out, because on Monday when I picked up my trailer, my six axle trailer, I had to go in the yard there and collect it myself. And I'll tell you now, I wasn't a happy puppy on Monday, because that is full of mud. Absolutely disgusting. My truck was covered in mud, even though I came here with nice shiny wheels and all that. Anyway, we're here now. Let's see what is going on. Are they gonna bring the trailers out for us? I hope so. One is here. I can see this red one. Woohoo. We need another one. Right. We've got the trailers. One is this one here, the red one. And there's another one, a blue one, inside. The good thing is, it's not in the muddy bit. It's just in the loading bay there. It's been inspected or checked over, whatever. So it's good to go. I think I'm gonna take that one, since Steve is not here. He's just popped into the toilet. Oh, sorry, I'm just cleaning my breadcrumbs. So I'm gonna go pick up that one, and he can take this one, and then we're good to go. And I need to find out if I can take timbers from bloody Scarborough. Open sesame. It's not working. (11:501). That's the one in front. The blue one there. Fantastic. That's it. So we're going to William Hare's. I'm not going back to the yard to pick up timbers, sorry. I'm just trying to find out the best way to go. Steve, go straight to William Hare.
Straight to Scarborough?
Yeah. Yeah.
Please drive to highlighted route.
Yeah, there's no point. There's no point in going back to the yard and all that. It's I forgot to put my number plate, you know. God. Come on, let's try again.
Continue on Doncaster Road.
So we're gonna go straight to William Hare in Scarborough and we're going to be there at 20 to 12, which is all right, not bad. We'll see if they load us straight away or we're going to have to wait, but yeah, we're good. We are good. We are on A614. We're going slow now because we are behind a tractor. It's so beautiful around here. You go through small villages with nice houses and fields and animals on the fields, and it's beautiful, absolutely beautiful. It's been a very long time since I've been this way. Sun is trying to make an appearance, which is good. The sky is clear a little bit. Oh, I remember this. I remember this. This is a farm here. I've been a long time since I've been around here. Very long time. Look at this van, this caravan parked in the escape lane.
After 300 yards, turn right, A64.
My God, man.
Turn right at the traffic light. Turn right.
If I needed that, they were laughing. Everything was like, woohoo, we are in our caravan, look at us.
Enter the roundabout.
We're here. Finally. I think.
Will you just check this for me, Floss? Because I think it's crabbing a little bit to the left. Maybe first time pulling one, I'm not sure.
No, if you feel like it's crabbing, it's probably crabbing. No. are you like straight now? Did you drive in straight?
Yes, mate.
Right, so your light is not on there.
Yeah.
Look here.
No.
Right. God knows how you use them chains and binders. Right, I've only ever used ratchets and I've only ever done caravans. Now he's like, yeah, get your chains and binders and do that.
I'll show you.
Generally don't. Once I'm sure.
No, it's all right. We'll show you.
No worries, mate.
We'll show you.
Chains,
yeah.
No worries, pal.
You see this?
Oh yeah.
Blue light. It means that you're straight.
All
so
right.
Like, so you probably need to wiggle a little bit until we see a blue light here.
Right.
Try up. Try maybe to go. Just go very slowly, a little bit to the right, maybe. Yeah. Left. Yeah, that's it. Stop it there. If you look at your wheels,
yeah,
they are turning
slightly
that way, yeah.
Yeah.
And then you start your remote.
Yep.
And then you have left or right, but if you press these two, it should align.
Yeah.
So I press them too, look.
Oh, yeah.
It should be...
Should be straight.
Fine now.
Yeah, yeah.
You can leave that on if you want.
Yeah.
And as long as you go below 12 miles an hour,
yeah.
10 or 11 miles an hour,
you should be able
to... You can...
Correct it.
So when you drive, just...
Yeah,
do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Thank you very much, pal. I'll stick this... I'll take it wheel, I'll be getting loaded while after dinner. After the beef for the lunch, you know.
Right, let's show you this guy.
Yeah.
So then, just tighten it up, and that's it.
Correct,
that's it, yeah. And you have that one pulling that, and this one's pulling that. And, yeah. So that's it. They are on brake now. When they come out of brake, we're gonna find out what pieces are we gonna be loading. It's some of them. Some of them are the back there. But they're gonna have to use a crane, I think. One of the mobile cranes to put them on. So, yeah, we're gonna have to pull up here in front, open the trailer, and let them load. And that's it. I guess I shall see you in a couple of seconds, all right? See you in a bit. Okay. We are extending the trailer now. I think it's on the other side, isn't it?
I think so.
Yeah.
Oh.
I need to extend 4 meters, I think. That's it. We're locked in. I'm just pulling here, so... can clear a little bit the yard. Let that truck pull out, and then I can go back in the middle of the yard.
Thanks for your help.
No problem, mate. Bless him. He didn't know how to use the chains, so he came and asked. Showed him how to use the chains and all that. And then also one of the binders was stuck. And he didn't know. It was like, I've only moved caravans before this. I don't know how to use the chains and binders and all that. That's all right, mate. We'll show you. Not a problem. Okay, so trailer is extended. They're gonna load me first, obviously, because I'm here positioned, not because I'm flawed. they're gonna load me first, and I still need to take to have a 30 minutes break because I was in the middle of my break. I was 20 minutes in and they told me to move so they can pull the piece out. So obviously break was interrupted. Counts only 15 minutes. So I still need 30 minutes to reset my driving time. I should have plenty. By the time I'm done chaining and all that, they have to also load him, you know, Steve, and then he needs to chain as well his load. So yeah, we have plenty of time. But morning, evening embargo starts again, I think 4 o'clock. It's only 1 minute to one now, so it's gonna be 1 o'clock in a minute. We still can make some progress, I think. I think so. But we'll find out. Once we can leave from here, we'll find out what time we have. Do you want me to get another ones?
Yes, mate, but you know that it's all free just to get them out.
The big ones, yeah. have to remove them bars with a forklift, I think. So that's the last beam. Now I can move forward. I'll move on the other side, on the right side of the... That's it. Now I can chain the load. Just moving slowly because there's nothing on the load to hold it. And that's it. Hey! Ready to put some chains on this load. Whew. Let's do this. Right, two chains on. I've got three more to go, obviously at the back, but the process is the same, except that at the back I don't have the holes there, so I'm gonna have to put them over the load, if that makes sense. It's not hard, but just requires a little bit more effort. But that's it. We're done. There you go. Two chains at the front and three at the back. All nice and tight. We're ready to go. I'm just waiting for my colleague. There he is. Beauty. There you go. So that's it really. It's 2:10 now. I've had another 30 minutes break as well, so I've reset my driving time. We can move anytime soon. I still have to discuss with him to see where we're going, actually. If we keep going until we run out of time, and we'll see where that is, because we need to be in a safe place for this kind of loads, isn't it? But not bad, not bad at all. There you go. Beautiful. We're still here. We didn't go anywhere. What was it? 2:10 when I was telling you that we're gonna go. But then we realized that South Yorkshire and North Yorkshire now, they have an embargo from 3 to 6. South Yorkshire has changed recently. It used to be 4. North Yorkshire, it used to be 3:30 to 6, and now it's 3 to 6 as well. So I think they're going to try to do the whole Yorkshire to be the same. So we're gonna have to wait until 6 o'clock. It's only 4 o'clock now. So, not good. Right, we are ready to go. It's 6 o'clock. We're gonna head towards Junction 28 and then maybe start again in the morning and before the embargo and make our way closer to the place. That's the plan. We will see. In the meantime, my OnlyFans is not working anymore, I see. The fan that I have here to cool down the front camera is not working, so... are we good to go, mate?
Just follow me where you are, mate.
Right, perfect. So let's go. We've been here long enough. But that's it. It's going to take 1 hour and 40 minutes to get to M18. We still have to go on the M62 and then follow it around to go on M18. So that's 1 hour and 40 minutes. And then from there, it's not long to Junction 28. But we have to go through the roadworks on M1. Which is not really good, but it is what it is. Oh my God, the sun! Woohoo! I really need to do something with that that fan of mine, because, like I said earlier, that's the fan that blows on the front camera and keeps it cool. Otherwise, it will overheat and stops working if it's too hot. But hopefully, we'll be all right.
Go left on the roundabout and take the first exit.
Let me know where you're going. Nobody's indicating. Nobody. Right, if you go for it, go for it. Don't just look at it, look. Wow. Oh, God. Anyway, guys, I'll see you later on. Okay? See you in a bit. Okay, I know you can't see me. You can probably see me now. We didn't make it to where we tried to make it. Because of road closures ahead, Junction 28 would have been at 9:37. That's when we would arrive there. And if there is no space, then I only had, 23 minutes left. That's not good. We can't go anywhere from there. So we chose to be safe than sorry. So we are stopping on M18 right now. As you can see in front of me, there's some cones. There's another bit after this one, and that's where we're gonna stop for the night. And I shall see you in the morning, all right? Good morning again. Just like that. It's 5:26 in the morning. We're gonna start soon at 5:30. I actually had a good sleep last night, to be honest. I was just looking now on my sat nav. The road closures are gone now, obviously, and it takes an hour from here to get to Junction 28, which is not bad. But I was trying to see if we can make it to Leicester Forest East. Well, it takes almost 2 hours to get there, so we're gonna go. We would go over the embargo time, so I'm afraid we have to stop at Junction 28. I think so. Are we ready?
Yes, mate, ready. I'm willing when you are, pal.
And that's it. Let's go, people. Let's go. We got to be careful when we pull out, obviously, from here. As soon as we have a gap, we'll go for it. Might take a while. These cars. We're all right. Hey, back in business. That's great. So, as you can probably see, it's dark. I can't see very much. So I'll see you guys when we are getting close to Junction 28. All right? I'll see you in a bit. So here we are on M1, approaching Junction 28 now. Hopefully we will have some space there. Last time, 2 days ago, when I stopped there, it was quite full, to be honest. All the right side, as you go in, all the right side was blocked off. There was a dumped trailer as well, just at the end. So
after 800 yards,
we had to park on the left side
and take the second exit towards the south.
Not a problem, but nobody else could pass. And there was a truck that wanted to leave a little bit earlier, like, mate, but you are wide. He said, yeah, but I need to go. Yeah, but you can't go. You can't go before 9 o'clock, isn't it? And like, no. So he was a little bit not happy, but what can you do?
500 yards, cross the roundabout and take the second exit,
and then to top it off, our escort driver, he dropped us here, and then he went in the services, and then he didn't come back till about 9:15. So these people were fuming a little bit, but what can you do? We're gonna have a little bit of trouble, I guess. Oh, it's empty, nobody here. I guess we're gonna have a little bit of trouble getting out. We're gonna have to watch ourselves, watch our exit, because obviously we have to give way to the incoming traffic.
Take the exit, then left.
So, I don't know. We're gonna have to work it out to see how we're gonna do it. The problem is, as soon as one side gets a red light, this side that's coming from here in the roundabout, they already shoot, and then the other way around. When this one is got red light, the other ones are shooting. Like, it's gonna be hard to get out to block the traffic. But it is what it is. Can't do anything about it, I'm afraid. When we get out, I think he's gonna have to watch my exit, kind of, and let me know when it's safe to go out, because that's my blind spot. I can't really see much there. We're gonna have to work together to get out of here. It's not easy. Anyway, we are here now. It's almost 7:15. We're gonna be here till 9 o'clock. The joys. I'm gonna have a coffee, I'm gonna have some breakfast, and then, I don't know, put my head down a little bit, but I'm not tired now. I'm gonna be tired just before we get out. Oh, before I go anywhere, I wanna show you something. And I wanna say a massive thank you to John for sending me this little beauty. Look at it, and it extends as well. It's one of them, there you go, Eddie Stobart rail trucks. I'm chuffed, honestly. John, thank you very much for the gift. He sent it to me during transport. One of the exhaust stacks broke. I've got it though. It was in the pack there. It was in the wrap. So I'm gonna glue it together. But it is what it is. I'll sort it. Don't worry about it. But it's lovely. Thank you very much, John. He also sent me a card. I don't have it here right now. But I will get it. Anyway, he sent me a card and he said, I hope you like it, Flo's. Signed, John. John, thank you very much for this. Appreciate it. It stays, right now, on the dashboard, just between dashboard and windscreen there. So it's visible. Sometimes it rolls when I turn. It goes that way and it comes back. So, yeah. Thank you very much, John. Appreciate it. And by the way, you know, Stobart's and many other companies, they named the trucks. This one was called Lily Jean. Lily Jean, I don't know if you can see, it could be too small there. Maybe it's not in focus. I don't know. Hopefully you can see Lily Jean. Anybody know the history? Anybody drove Lily Jean? There it is. I've got a model of it. It's an and then they also have an internal number, which is RY233. Registration number PX58. BMB. BMB. Yeah, the light is not very good here, but anyway. Stobart Rail, there you go. Lily Jean is here with me. Love it, absolutely love it. And this detaches as well, look, so you can get the unit only. But yeah, thank you very much, John. Appreciate it. Are we ready, pal?
Yes, mate, ready when you are, pal.
Let's see. I can't really see that incoming. Would you let me know when these people in the roundabout that is coming now have a red light?
Possible, mate.
Not easy, not easy.
Guys, stop in now, close off you go, mate.
Off, come on, follow me. That's it. We've done it. So now it takes 2 hours and 20 minutes to get to Brackley. We're gonna be there at approximately 11:20, just like we normally do. So that's it really.
Go left on the roundabout and take the first exit, A422.
Come on, come on! I love the sound. I love the sound. Now, I said it earlier, my fan that I have it here on the ceiling, basically, on the sun visor, I have a fan blowing on that front camera because there's no air circulation here, even though I have my aircon on, but where the camera is, there is no air circulation, all right? So it gets hot. When it gets hot, it shuts down. It don't record anymore. I mean, it's not shutting down, but it stops recording. Sometimes I have to open my my windows a little bit, and that's what I'm gonna do actually. Let some air in. But I need to order a new fan. Same style like this one. It was actually working very well, but unfortunately it's not spinning. So a new OnlyFans is on order. Let's hear this temporary bridge noise. This is where the train is going. It's going both ways. So that's it. We're here now. We are here. Slowly. And that's it. Perfect. Let's see. Last time when I came, they wanted to hear my lift indicator and my reversing beep. You all right?
Again and again,
yeah.
What's your name?
Florin.
Okay, left signal.
He wants to hear the left signal and the reversing beep. Right, so let's mark it here that we're gonna be accepted at the gate. All good. Accepted at the gate. It's a bit chilly today, 16 degrees, but feels like, go on, feels like winter is coming. Well, it is coming. This chap here, he is always happy, always smiling and greeting you with a big smile. Look at him. Thank you. Told you, he's brilliant. Cheers, Paul. Thank you. Where are we going? We're gonna wait here, I think, to see which one goes in first. You see, they're moving the crane. But these ones on the left, these are the ones that we brought. Yeah, come next to me. They need to find out which one goes in first. All right. How are you?
I'm all right. Well, I'd say this is only a good guess.
Yeah.
This is first.
All right. We'll see.
Yeah. Well, it goes at that end and it goes at that end. Back. So, it's the right way around.
Is it? That's a first.
Yeah. Unless it's the wrong piece.
That'll be fun. We can start removing chains. Inside. Yeah.
I'll get dressed.
Yeah, get dressed. Put some clothes on.
Yeah.
Driving naked. You.
Whatever floats your boat for.
Yeah. The thing is with these, they are kind of waterproof. I get so sweaty. When I finish with these today, these pants will be soaking wet. You know, the pants that I already have, they'll be soaking wet. But it is what it is, isn't it? So what happens now is they're gonna put that spreader beam on, that clips onto the edges of this Yorkshire bar. And then they're gonna have to connect the other side of the hooks, let's say. They've got to get it, in the middle. Otherwise, it's gonna tip to one side, and it's not good. That, obviously. And then when they're ready, we're gonna have lift off. And let me just show you where they go. See, these are the 40 ton pieces that we brought on Tuesday. We dropped them here. And at the other side, they've already connected the 30 tons that were brought yesterday. And this one and my colleagues are going on that side, so they are just attaching them and then welding them, just like the one behind there, as you can see. And these ones here as well. So that's a 30 ton piece. In the middle is a 40 ton, and then at the other side is another 30 ton. And then obviously sometime they're gonna have to start lifting them and make the actual bridge, but don't know when that's gonna happen. The crane, it's not that big, but it can lift some heavy stuff. Look at that. Imagine bringing this crane here, how complicated it would be, because everything, the trucks come off, that come off, the bit there, that's gonna be on a separate truck, maybe two trucks, because it's very, very long. The weights are on another truck, and so on. So they bring it here in pieces and they assemble it. But yeah, it's quite massive, isn't it? And we're gonna have lift off. I think so. There is some tension in the cables. So I'm guessing it's gonna start to lift it. Yes. Come on, come on, come on. I can see lifting at the back, and that's it. It's off. Bye-bye. Go do your job. I'm gonna do my job in a minute. Okay. This is it. Now I'm gonna have to close my trailer, and then we can carry on. So the way you close the trailer is underneath here. You have the trailer brake. All that. Now we have to release the pins, and we're doing it by pushing that. That came out somewhere over there. I don't know if you can see. There's the pins. That one is still on, so I have to wiggle it a little bit, but you'll hear that big noise. And that means the pins have come out. So let me just put this camera here. I'm just going back and forth. That's it. That noise tells me that the pin is out, and I can just slowly close my trailer. That's it. Now obviously you have to do the reverse. You have to push that pin button. That needs to go in. So when I pull this, it goes in. And I just put this safety clip just to make sure that everything is fine. It should be all right. Don't forget, like I just did, to release the trailer brake. And that's it. We're good to go now. I'm just gonna reverse and let my colleague take my place, and then I'm gonna sort my timber. I need to sort it on the trailer, and then we can go. That's it, pal. Yes, I'll sort my timber. Yeah. No, take it with. Yeah, leave it on the trailer when you drop the trailer. Yeah, because you're gonna do the same job, innit? It's gonna be, you're gonna need them. So, yeah. Yeah. Won't be long though. They just put it on the on that thing and then you know. We're going. Cheers, pal. See you later. He's already managed to get a 45 minutes break in, which is good. My front camera just stopped recording. This one stopped when I said. Anyway, I'm not gonna say it again. I'm just gonna reverse and get out of here. Start recording. It's still hot. Anyway, nothing to see that we haven't seen yet. It's just my way out of here. I need to get out, obviously. I've got 2 hours, 2 hours and 5 minutes until I need a 45 minutes break, but I'm gonna take it sooner. I'm hungry, actually. I am hungry. So as soon as I'm on 8:43, maybe, I'll stop in a Levi and cheers, pal. And have a 45 minutes break, yeah? So I shall see you after that. All right, I'll see you in a bit. Oh, there's Richard. We're back in the yard. I've just dropped the trailer and I haven't finished yet. It's 20 past five now. I still have to refill the unit and give it a wash. I have to give it a wash outside and I need to clean the inside as well because it's full of dust. Dust is everywhere. And after that we can clock off. I don't have anything else on my work phone. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching. I do appreciate it. I hope you liked the vlog. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done it yet. And hit the bell button to enable notifications. That's the only way you will be notified when I upload a new vlog. And until later, bye-bye. Love you all.